Do I want to activate audio? Yes. Alright, good day everyone, AquaMac93 here. So, I thought I would start a Let's Play on this rather obscure game, which I believe was originally for Game Boy, maybe, and then has since been ported over to iOS. So, first off, I'd like to apologize ahead of time for the potentially poor quality of the resolution of this recording. Unfortunately, because this game is so old and I guess isn't coded up to iOS, modern iOS standards, I've turned my phone on landscape here. However, unfortunately, it's still streaming to my TV in portrait. So what I'm going to have to do is go into post-production, flip it around, crop off the sides to make it look proper. However, it's going to screw up the resolution at the same time. So again, I apologize for that at this point. So I guess we'll get started with this game here. And basically, what you do is you go through and do all these tasks to unlock more characters. And that's basically how you beat the game. So we're going to start off with the cup races. So as you can see, here's the first cup. And the second and third ones are locked. Second, third, and fourth cups, sorry, are locked. And we can't get to them right now. So we'll just start off with the first one, which is comprised of Bandicoot Beach, Haunted Hovel, and Mayan Mayhem. So yeah, here's the characters you get to start off with. There's Crash, Nina, Coco, Cortex, and that's it. So I'm going to go with Crash for now. Sorry, that button is hard to hit at the bottom right. Anyways, here we go. So this is the second Crash Nitro Kart to be released on iOS. There was an earlier one, but unfortunately it's so old and out of date. I remember I used to be able to play it on my old iPhone 3G back around 2008, 2009. However, it hasn't been updated in so many years that it actually just crashes every time I try to run it. I don't think you can even buy the game anymore, to be honest. I still have it in my iOS app library because I bought it way back when, but it's not even offered, I suppose, because the developers haven't updated it to the current iOS standards. So that means that Apple won't allow them to sell any new copies of it until they do. So as soon as that starts working, I might do a Let's Play of that too. But for now, we're going to start with the second one. So as you can see, there's all the standard sort of power-ups you'd expect from the Crash Racing series. Is the Aku mask, as we have here. Unfortunately, unless you have full Wampas, it doesn't hurt any other players when you... Oh, crap. Damn it! Blasted. Anyways, it won't hurt any other players until you get 10 Wampa Fruit. So that's sort of annoying. But it will protect you from rockets and whatnot. Anyways, as you can see, you can slide in this game, but I'm not sure if there possibly was power sliding originally, but it doesn't seem like you can do that anymore, so. Lap 2-3. So obviously this Bandicoot Beach is just a ripoff of Insanity Beach from Crash Team Racing, the original racing game for PS1 that Naughty Dog developed. Fuck. Shit. You know, you might as well not use that power up when you go on the bridge because it's just so... The controls are just so... You know, typical iOS touchscreen controls, I guess. They're not the easiest things to use. Because obviously, like I said, this was meant to be for, you know, one of the handhelds in the 2000s. I'm sorry, I don't know which one it is. I'll look it up and let you know next episode. Anyways. And... Yeah, we got it. Alright, yeah, so you get 6 points for winning and then obviously less points for not. And then you have to get the most points at the end of the cup in order to win it and then make it to the next one. So here we are, Haunted Hovel. I'd say this environment reminds me of, it would either be, if it were to be attributed to any of the characters, it might either be Cortex or Nina, just given by the creepiness of it. It kind of reminds me of the atmosphere from the Academy of Evil and Crash to Insanity, if any of you guys have ever played that game. Crash to Insanity is a pretty, it's a decent Crash game, I think. It probably is a lot better than the reputation it has. But the one thing that's really awful in that game is collecting the gems. Just because there's all kinds of tacked on little sort of side platforming missions you have to do, which really just don't work for the game in my opinion. So again, I don't know if you can get any boosts from those power slides, but you can slide. So when your character cheers like that, that means that it means that a weapon that you've dropped successfully has derailed one of your opponents. So the more you hear that, the better, I suppose. You know, I'd say the general steering in this game is alright, like when you're turning just like this. The power sliding though is, it could really be tweaked. It's just, it's subpar, to be honest. It's very subpar. Oh shit. I missed the jump. Oh geez, they're close behind me. If that shield thing was able to hit someone. Fuck. Oh god. Oh no. Oh. That's such bullshit. That's the cheapest weapon ever. You're out in front, you think everything's alright, and then all of a sudden you're dragged back by some kind of space warping thing. I don't even know what that weapon's supposed to be. Like, is it supposed to be something from Crash 3 where the time twisting machine has the warp devices that warp space and time? Yeah, the power-ups in this game are definitely questionable in my opinion. Alright, so obviously this is the knockoff of Papenkaper's Pyramids. This beginning bit right here reminds me a little bit actually of Donkey Kong Mountain from Mario Kart Double Dash. Now there's a shortcut here which, well, I guess I'll try. Oh, crow. We're not gonna make it. Oh, okay. We made it by the skin of our teeth there. You know, the soundtrack to this game actually is pretty decent, considering it's a iOS game. Or mobile game, I should say. I don't know if it was ever released on Android. I guess I really should have researched it more before I decided to do a Let's Play on it, but you know, spur of the moment kind of a thing. Oh, Jesus! such bullshit. You know, definitely since Crash Team Racing, the dialogue of the characters has gone downhill. I think the best was probably Cortex back in the day, when he used to pass you, he'd yell out, he'd just be like, "Trophy's mine!" as he's driving by you, and it was pretty funny. And then Engine, I remember, had some pretty funny lines too. I'm not even sure the Engine's in this game, to be honest. Now, one thing is, the second Crash Nitro Kart for mobile is definitely much better than the graphics of the first one. The first one, you could barely tell who the characters were. Anyways, there we are, first place. Congratulations, you've completed the cup in the top three. Okay, so apparently you only have to get the top three. Okay. Jeez. Okay, new cup unlocked. Time attack mode unlocked. Bandicoot Beach. Alright, awesome. Alright, everyone, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next part.